See, this very unfortunate that what has happened in Bihar yesterday, especially it happened absolutely in the heart of my constituency, Asansol, of which Raniganj is an integral part. I have a simple question to ask the authorities that if they had to impose 144, if they had to send so many SI branch police officers, if they had to send, if the Trinamool Netas and ministers, and if they had needed to go to those places, they had been there yesterday as well. But why wasn't these things done yesterday? Why wasn't 144 there when I visited the places right after those shops were burned down, where people were attacked in those narrow byways? Why did police sit quiet and allow the perpetrators to come inside, slaughter, do whatever damage they wanted to do, beat shops, beat individuals? They did that, and they had the safe haven to actually flee, actually run away to their safe heavens. And then it was only after that that the police responded and came to those areas. And today, as you see on television, even on national television, it is very obvious from the footage that there is a lot of presence of police, lot of police officers, lot of star marked police officers, and the ministers of Trinamool Congress going there, speaking to the those shops which have been burned down, that don't worry, the state government is with you, they are going to give you right amount of compensation to rebuild your shop. They're going to the people and saying that the state government is going to give you all kind of security. My question is, why is it all cured and all in the name of dirty appeasement politics? Where was the prevention? Where was police when all this was happening yesterday? Why is it that everywhere police reaches a spot after the fire has been ignited, after people have been injured, and people have been killed? And how helpless has this state government under the leadership of Mamata Banerjee, how helpless has she turned that Kolkata police or West Bengal police into that, deputy commissioner of police rank officer can actually lose a hand? I have seen that. I was in the spot immediately after those things happened, and trust me, I reached there. Law and order is a state subject. I realized yesterday, in spite of being the public, the representative who has won with the largest number of votes there, I definitely want more votes than any of the MLAs there. But yet, the law and order, the constitution of the country bars an MP to go to a place where the state government has imposed 144, or where there is a chance of any kind of increasing or escalation of the tension that is already there. There was nothing yesterday. I actually visited the houses of the people there, and it is all documented in the videos that I have myself posted and sent to many of you here, sitting here in front of me. It clearly shows the victims saying that the police were not to be seen for the 2 hours when those rampage was happening. My question, simple question, is those people there, I did not choose the lanes, whether it's a lane which has Trinamool workers in it, where I can get attacked, where it's a lane which has minorities in it. I'm not going to use the minority as well, because the mob that attacked, it had Trinamool supporters in there. And if I had reached there a little earlier, the entire blame for the the incident would have been put on BJP, would have been put on Babu Supriyo, as going there and inciting violence. My question is very simple. Why this is happening after the incidents take place, after people are losing lives, after police is getting injured? Somewhere they have been sent to coma, being attacked by party supporters, Trinamool party supporters. Somewhere they are losing their hand. What is this happening? And Ram Navami and Mohurram or it coexisted in Bengal for a very long time. I have grown up in a place called Bandel, where 500 meters on either side of my house, there was the Bandel church and there was the Imambara. I have from this year, because now this is some kind of, I don't know whether it is course correction, whether it is another dirty example of vote bank politics. It has started from this year. It coexisted in Bengal. There was no problem. There used to be Durga Puja. There was never a ban on Durga Puja immersion, because there it was coinciding or overlapping with Mohurram. I'm sure it has happened in the past as well. But now this is becoming a problem, because this is a very simple example. If I may give it to you, it's simply bribery. If there are 2 children that parents have, and if there is one child who is given extra special care, extra attention, extra love by the parent, it is very obvious that the other child is going to have anger, anger locked inside, and that anger is going to come out in some form. I think this dirty appeasement vote bank politics that what Mamata Banerjee has done for these years in the name of change or in the name of administration, I think that is what has incited people everywhere. And tomorrow, this playing of fire is going to cost life of humanity. It's going to cost lives of people who have got nothing to do with politics, who has got nothing to do with BJP, Trinamool Congress or CPIM. Let's understand that West Bengal is a big state, and everyone in West Bengal is not associated with politics. Everyone in West Bengal is not coming out with Ram Navami or Mohram celebrations. Therefore, this kind of arson, this kind of incidents are happening on West Bengal, in West Bengal, it is generally public, irrespective of their caste, creed, religion or party color, they are all getting affected. And at 5:30 we have got an appointment from Honorable Governor. I am going to him. It's not about 350cc, it's not, people do not know as an MP how helpless I felt in Asansol yesterday. Law and order is a state subject, and therefore whether 144 needs to be imposed or not is a decision that the state had to take. Whether central forces can be sent to a place to control a situation if it is out of control is a decision that the state has to take. The constitution does not allow the center to just send in central forces. It does not allow the MP to walk into a place with his own CRPF or central forces to tone down a place or to calm down a place. No, I can't do that. That is the same subject. And people who are writing on Facebook and Twitter asking me to go inside and do something, they don't understand that the moment I do that, we are going to have a few more miscreants from the ruling party creating attention and blaming that on me. So I am going to go to the governor. We are going to go to the governor to appraise him of the entire situation. And let me tell you, my biggest question is why weren't this 144 imposed yesterday? What was the police doing for the 2 hours? As I've been documented in the videos that I've circulated, what were they doing in those houses? Why weren't those houses given protection when they were attacked? Why is it always a cure and that too in deceit and not prevention? Because there was already the government had already said, and we all knew that there were chances of tension that could happen anywhere owing to this competition that was happening about Ram Navami. So it's an atrocious situation, and I think humanity as a whole is something that has been attacked in West Bengal. While our Honorable Chief Minister is trying to brush her prime ministerial aspirations in Delhi, where Bengal is burning in different places, I'm not even mentioning Gandhi. He's going to tell you about that. I'm very concerned about my own possibility. I might go back there, but once again, even if I go back, I cannot go and visit those places because again, law and order is a state subject. The MP is bound and restricted by the constitution to not breach that. As a minister also, I cannot breach those and go there. But if those police officers needed to be there, if 144 needed to be imposed, why weren't they imposed yesterday? Why did a particular section of shops, why did they get burned? Why did a particular section of the community get hurt in the entire process? And what was police doing for those 2 hours before imposing 144? Something that was needed, something that was the need of the hour when the dispositions were attacked by miscreants from outside. That's all I have to say.
तो क्या लगता है कितने कारगर साबित हो सकती है?
नहीं, अब इसके बारे में मैं कुछ कहूंगा नहीं, क्योंकि ये सवाल का जवाब तो आपके पास ही है। अब मैं आपको बता देता हूँ, ममता दीदी मीटिंग करेंगे, बोलेंगे कि देखिए प्राइम मिनिस्टर आपको बनना है शरद पवार जी, कहेंगे कि अरे ऐसे कैसे हो सकता है, हम इतने दिन से क्या पावर मिल रहे हैं। फिर उधर से राहुल गांधी बोलेंगे आप कमाल की बात कर रहे हैं, मैं कांग्रेस का प्रेसिडेंट हूँ, प्राइम मिनिस्टर बनना मेरा फंडामेंटल राइट है, तो आप कैसी ऐसी बात करते हैं? तो मैं तो आपको स्क्रिप्ट पहले से बता दूँ, और कृपा करें वो बिल्कुल करें, ये डेमोक्रेटिक कंट्री है, हमको जो करना है वो बिल्कुल करें, लेकिन पुलिस मंत्री होने के नाते उनको यहीं पे रहना चाहिए, कोई तो बंगाल में रहना चाहिए था। प्राइम मिनिस्टर बनने के लिए और भी टाइम है, कल जाते परसों जाते, आज तो उनको कलकत्ता में होना चाहिए था, नहीं है वो। और दूसरी बात, कम से कम अगर आप इसी तरीके का कोई शुरुआत करने जा रहे, कोई फ्रंट हो, बैक हो, जो भी हो, कम से कम उसे थर्ड फ्रंट मत कहिएगा, क्योंकि पूरी दुनिया को मालूम है कि थर्ड फ्रंट, फोर्थ फ्रंट, फिफ्थ फ्रंट, सिक्स फ्रंट सारे फेल हो चुके हैं। अगर आप सेवन फ्रंट बोलेंगे तो शायद वो मतलब आधिकारिक रूप से या इन टर्म्स ऑफ व्हाट शुड आई से इवन इन डॉक्यूमेंटल थिंग इट इज गोइंग टू बी करेक्ट, इट इज कॉल्ड द सेवंथ फ्रंट। उसको जो करना है करने दीजिए, सेंट्रल हॉल में काफी गड़बड़ी मचा के रखी है मैंने सुना है, पर कुछ होने वाला नहीं।
बोलो एक बार स्पेसिफिक होते जाइए, 356 দ্বারা প্রয়োগের জন্য কি আপনারা রাজ্যপালের কাছে আর্জি জানাচ্ছেন, নাকি আগে বিজেপি যে কেন্দ্রীয় হস্তক্ষেপ চেয়েছিল এর আগে তো লয়ন একটা সিচুয়েশন নিয়ে আপনারা অভিযোগ করেছেন, সেটা থেকে আবার সেন্ট্রাল এরকম হস্তক্ষেপ কিছু চাইছেন?
দেখুন, গভর্নরের কাছে গিয়ে প্রথমত যে এমন সিচুয়েশনটা হয়েছে, আর্জি যে একটা চোখে ধুয়ে দেওয়ার জন্য যে দেখানো হচ্ছে সব জায়গায় পুলিশ হয়েছে, সব রয়েছে, এই উনিও তো টিভি দেখছেন, ওনাকে গিয়ে আসল পরিস্থিতি আমি এই ব্যাপারে সত্যি কোনো নোংরা রাজনীতি করতে চাই না, আমি ওনাকে প্রকৃত অবস্থাটা জানাতে চাই। আবার বলছি মাইনরিটি মাইনরিটি মেজরিটি ছেড়ে দিন, হিউম্যানিটি ইজ অ্যাট স্টেক। ওখানে পাঁচা পাঁচা ছেলেরা আজকে ক্লাস টুয়েলভে পরীক্ষা দিচ্ছে, আপনি ভাবুন তো আপনি ছেলেগুলোকে পরীক্ষার জায়গায় পৌঁছে দেবেন না, সেই হিন্দু মুসলিম বিজেপি তৃণমূল এটা দেখবে। তো কোথাও না কোথাও আমাদের নিজেদের আয়নাতে তো নিজেদের মুখটা দেখতে হবে। কোনো 356 ধারা এর আগে অনেক এসব হয়েছে, 356 পশ্চিমবঙ্গে আমার মনে হয় সমস্ত পরিস্থিতি প্রকৃত পরিস্থিতি যদি মানুষের সামনে আসে, উই আর ভেরি ক্লোজ টু 356। আর আজকে আমি মূলত আমরা যাচ্ছি রাজ্যপালের কাছে ওনাকে গ্রাউন্ড সিচুয়েশন, যেহেতু আমি ওখানকার এমপি হিসেবে অন দ্য স্পট ওই জায়গায় থেকে সবকিছু নিজে দেখেছি, নিজে কথা বলেছি, আমি ওনাকে এই পুরো ব্যাপারটা মানে একদম ওয়ান টু ওয়ান ডিসিশন ওনাকে এটা জানাচ্ছি। I spoke to him yesterday, as exactly what I'm saying, you know, we have a constitution, it is a democratic country. I think probably when you buy a television set, it comes with a manual. I think people should know how the constitution works, what are the constraints of the center in terms of setting central forces. That has to be requested by the state government. I spoke to Rajnath Singh, he immediately said that he's going to speak to the DGP. He did. His OSC called me up, I got a call from his office in the night as well, saying that the information or the message has been sent. He spoke to the DGP, and as you can see, as I'm saying, there is police everywhere. So the central government will have to go by the report that the state government gives. Let's understand that. And as the report, as the television news says today, every corner you go, take a camera and go there. If I go to Raligarh, which I probably will in the night, let me see the situation. If I record stuff in that area, I'm going to see the same thing that there is police deployed everywhere. There are big police officers who are moving around. There is the law minister comes from there. They're all there. But the question is the gap between the lip and the cup. What was the police doing during those 1.5-2 hours? Why did these miscreants actually cause that rampage? That is the biggest question. That is the question that needs to be answered. So Rajnath Singh has done what he could do under the circumstances, but what transpires in the next few days is something that we all have to deal with.
The mayor of Assam is accusing you of politicizing the entire situation, the entire incident. Is accusing you of?
Well, you know, when an elephant walks, there will be a lot of other different kinds of creatures who want to create a lot of noise. I would like to drown the noises with some sane words, and I think that is what I have tried to speak. I'll keep to that. I don't want to answer to any of those. We already know what is the class quality, what kind of language the Trinamool leaders of Asansol uses. Unfortunately, they win all the time because I don't resort to that. I don't need to stoop down. I cannot even go there, even if I try. Yes.
So you have such a large follower on your Twitter. The issue was so sensitive yesterday. You put out such graphic content. But we did not get a tweet from you where you were asking for peace and calm. Do you think that could have added to the situation? Because you have such a large follower on the social media platform, and there were extremely graphic pictures and videos that you put out, including you pinpointed that it was a particular minority community that was behind the entire attack. Do you think that could have added to the tension there? Because we did not see any
I know what you're saying, but I have already instructed people, and I just said a little while back that I also don't believe all the calls that come to me about this, there is fire happening there. Didn't I say that a little while back? So what I tweeted yesterday are real pictures. They're not doctored. Let's understand that. Those are real pictures. There is no picture of violence. There is no picture of any particular political party, brandishing the sword or weapon. Did you see that in my tweets? No. I gave you the real people talking. The people, while they were saying that the police did not come, while our houses were attacked and they did not receive phone calls, the commissioner of police did not take my phone calls. It was all there. This is all truth that I put out. And in terms of calming for people down, trust me, please get your, footages from independent sources. You will find me standing in that neighborhood and asking people to calm down. I told them that just because I've come here, I'm not going to make any political comment. Because after all, I leave this place and I leave it at the mercy of the police to do the needful. Let's understand that. Babu Subri is not going to have a CRPF standing there, protecting the people. I cannot do that. The constitution doesn't allow me to do that. So I cannot inside, I ask my people, the BJP supporters to stay put and stay in their own places. There would have been a lot of things that we could have done in Bengal today, in Kolkata today, whether it is, doing some protest, doing pothokoro and all of that, which is very common. But we can't do that. We also have to keep in mind that the class 12 exam started from today. So I asked to keep the noise levels low. Did I ask anyone to come out on the streets? Did I ask them to protest? Go ahead and read all of that. There's nothing of that. So I just give a first hand account of what the reality of the situation is. And that's exactly what I'm doing now, Mr. আমি আর যাই করি না কেন, এদের এই নোংরামিটা ধরিয়ে দিতে গেলে আমাদের ওদের ফুলটাসগুলো আমি ফুলটাস মারতে দেবো না। আমি এমন কিছু করতে চাই না যাতে এরা এই নোংরামিটাকে এস্টাবলিশ করার সুযোগ পেয়ে যায়। আমি ওখানে ছিলামই না, কিন্তু ঘটনাটা ঘটার ইমিডিয়েটলি পরে যখন যারা মানে আক্রান্ত তাদের হসপিটালে নিয়ে যাওয়ার পরে তাদের তারপরে আমি ওখানে গেছি, দমকলের সঙ্গে গিয়ে শান্ত মনে কথা বলেছি, কোথায় পুলিশ কোনো গিয়ে চেঁচামেচি করে কোনো সিন ক্রিয়েট করিনি, চুপচাপ গেছি, চুপচাপ চলে এসে আপনার ইন্ডিপেন্ডেন্ট সোর্সেস থেকে দেখে নিন। দেখুন, নোংরা পলিটিক্স করে ভোট জেতা যেতে পারে, নোংরা পলিটিক্স করে আপনি কি বল মানুষের চোখে ধুলো দিতে পারেন, কিন্তু যখন আপনি ওই জায়গায় গিয়ে আপনি সব দেখবেন, বিশেষ করে ওটা আমার আমার মধ্যেও নেই, আমি ওটা করতে পারবো না। আমি আবার আপনাদের বলছি, আপনার রিয়েল সিচুয়েশন যদি দেখেন এবং ওই লিপ্টান দেখ একটা কাপের মধ্যে যে গ্যাপটা, যে এক ঘন্টা দেড় ঘন্টা র্যাম্পেজ করতে দেওয়া হচ্ছে তারপরে পুলিশ পাঠানো হচ্ছে, যে খেলাটা রাজ্য সরকারের, এইটা আপনারা যদি হাইলাইট করতে পারেন, যদি আপনারা নিজেরা মানে পর্যালোচনা করেন, আপনার সত্যিটা জলের মতো আপনার সামনে চলে আসবে। আমি তো আবার বলছি কথা হচ্ছে যে যখন মারামারি হবে বা যখন হিন্দু মুসলমান হোক বা তৃণমূল বিজেপি যখন মারামারি হবে, কোনো না কোনো পার্টি, আমি বারবার বলছি যে এখানে মাইনরিটি মেজরিটি এগুলো প্রশ্ন নয়, হিউম্যানিটি ইজ আ থ্রেট, যে কেউ মারা যেতে পারে, কোনোদিন মাইনরিটি গেছে, কোনোদিন তৃণমূলের যাবে, কোনোদিন বিজেপি যাবে, কোনোদিন কংগ্রেসের যাবে, মৃত্যু গণনা করতে হবেই। এবং আবার বলছি যে রামনবমীর মিছিল তো বিজেপি পশ্চিমবঙ্গে নিয়ে আসেন, এটা তো বিজেপি নিয়ে আসেনি, একদমই তো তা নয়। সেটা যদি হতো তাহলে মমতা ব্যানার্জি এবছর চারদিকে রামনবমীর এত শুভেচ্ছা বার্তা সব জায়গায় করতেন না, পাঠাতেন না, তৃণমূল কংগ্রেসকে বলতেন না রামনবমীর মিছিল পাঠাবো, এটা তো কালেক্টিভ একটা উনি ইয়ে করার চেষ্টা করছেন। তো এই ধরনের অ্যালিগেশনের জবাব দিতে ইচ্ছে করে না সত্যি কথা বলছি, কারণ পুরোটাই এতটাই নোংরা মিলে ঢাকা, ওনারা যদি জবাব দিতে বলতো একই নোংরার পাকেটে নিজের একটা পালি করে ছেড়ে দিন, ওরা বলছে বলুন, আমি সত্যিটা আপনাদের সামনে সবভাবে আপনার সামনে আনার চেষ্টা করছি।
আচ্ছা, আমি বীরভূম মে অনুব্রত মন্ডল নে কাহা হ্যায় কি মহরম মে ও
পাগলের কিনা বলে ছাগলের কিনা, আপনার নিজেরাই দেখুন যে তৃণমূল কংগ্রেসে কত ধরনের পাগল আছে, কত ডায়ামেট্রিকলি অপোজিট কথা বলতে পারে। অনুব্রত মন্ডল সম্বন্ধে আমি কিছু বলবো না, বিকজ আই থিঙ্ক হি হ্যাজ আ মেডিকেল কন্ডিশন, অক্সিজেন ডাজ নট রিচ হিজ ব্রেন, আই ডোন্ট থিঙ্ক ইট ইজ গোইং টু বি অ্যাপ্রোপ্রিয়েট ফর মি টু মেক আ কমেন্ট অন ইট। ইন টার্মস অফ রবীন্দ্রনাথ ঘোষ, অল আই ক্যান সে ইজ দ্যাট ইজ আ বিগ, আই থিঙ্ক দ্যাট প্রবাবলি আই ডোন্ট নো হোয়েদার হি ওয়াজ ইন হিজ সেন্সেস হোয়েন হি সেড অল অফ দ্যাট, বাট ইফ সামওয়ান ক্যান বি, ইফ আ বিজেপি সাপোর্টার ক্যান বি অ্যারেস্টেড অ্যান্ড এফআইআর ক্যান বি লঞ্চড অন হিম, ক্যান বি লঞ্চড অন হিম ফর মেকিং ইনসিনুয়েটিং কমেন্টস, I think Rabindranath Ghosh should be booked for absolutely being pinpoint, identifying the person and spelling it out what he is going to do with the lathi in his hand. Unke upar ki FIR bilkul hona chahiye, unhone to Dilip Ghosh ko bilkul target kar diye baat kahi hai, Dilip ka to lathi ghuma rahe hai, to main bhi jo hai jinhone practice kiya hai wo bhi ghuma sakta hai, to isme to koi badi baat nahi hai, hum bhi bachpan mein Bruce Lee ka nancha ko ghumate the, jinme se aap log mein se bahut log ko aata hoga, lekin aap pinpoint karke aap bol rahe hai ki hum yahi karke Dilip Ghosh ka haath pair tod denge, muh tod denge, उसके खिलाफ एफ आई आर होना चाहिए, क्यों नहीं हो रहा है, राज्य सरकार क्या कर रही है उसके बारे में मुझे बताइए। और अनुब्रत मंडल के बारे में जैसे मैंने कहा है, हिंदी में भी बोल रहा हूँ, उनका एक मेडिकल कंडीशन है, उनके दिमाग में ऑक्सीजन नहीं पहुंचती है, खुद ऑनरेबल चीफ मिनिस्टर ने ये बात कही है, मैं उनके ऊपर कुछ भी बोल नहीं सकता।
बाबू दा, वी हैव सीन दैट सीरीज ऑफ एफआईआर्स हैव बीन फाइल्ड अगेंस्ट द बीजेपी लीडरशिप स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम डॉक्टर चटर्जी, दिलीप घोष, but in similar instance, even you and similar instance we have seen when Arjun Singh was leading a rally in Guwahati, in the similar fashion, the weapons were brandishing in his rally, but no action has been taken against him as yet. Do you think it's a dual politics or it's a political platform and that's why it's getting away?
See, that's exactly what I'm saying. That if coming out with weapons is something that is being barred by the state government, then there shouldn't be any problem with that, right? But that same law should apply for everyone. You cannot book the BJP or the Akharas. As I'm saying, BJP did not come up with Ram Navami Mishil. You know, if left can have a atheist stand, BJP has a Hindutva or the leaders have been Hindus and staunch Hindus. What is so wrong about it? We are not talking about anyone being a Muslim and being in politics. Then are you talking about that? No. So what is the problem in the same law applying on everyone? How can Arjun Singh, is he booked today? Please, can you please separate? I mean, enlighten me, is he booked for coming out with the arms? No. But if the same thing has been done by a BJP leader, he has been booked. Probably has been picked from his house and it's languishing in the jail. So that's what it is. That's the hypocrisy. That's the kind of politics that Mamata Banerjee is doing. And I think she is definitely not connected to Mahamati Manush. Otherwise, she wouldn't have been holding her prime ministerial aspirations in Delhi, at least today. She would have probably waited a couple of days. Because if she wants to visit Central Hall, the parliament session is on till the 6th. So she still has quite a few days to go and sit in Central Hall. It was not needed today. So that's what the reality is. पंचायत चुनाव अभी छोड़ दीजिए. पंचायत चुनाव में बहुत ही भयंकर संतराश होने वाली है. आपको भी मालूम है, हमारे यहाँ पे हिस्ट्री है इसका, तो हम उसके लिए तैयार हो रहे हैं. लेकिन एक चीज आपको बता दूं कि जिस तरीके का वायलेंस पे तृणमूल कांग्रेस उतरती है, वो सीपीएम का वायलेंस का अपग्रेडेड वर्जन है. उसके साथ बीजेपी वेपन लेके नहीं लड़ेगी. हमने भारतवर्ष में इस वक्त एनडीए बीजेपी और एनडीए 21 राज्य में क्षमता में है. और आपको ये बता दो, कर्नाटक में आपको बहुत भारी बहुमत मिलने वाली है. खुद भी होगा, कई बार गया 31st को भी बैंगलोर जा रहा हूँ, वो भी मैं आपको 22nd स्टेज आपको पहले से मैं बता देता. कहीं पे भी वेपन घुमा के हमने जीता नहीं. जहां जहां वेपन घुमा है उनका विनाश हुआ है, भले वो त्रिपुरा हो या असम हो, जहां पे भी जहां जहां पॉलिटिकल पार्टीज ने वेपन घुमा है उनका विनाश करके बीजेपी आई है. मंगानी की वही होगा इंशाल्लाह. ये आप देख लेते हैं. It's a strong word. It's something wrong.
দুটো জিনিস. একটা হচ্ছে যে আমরা রাজভবনে যাবো, সেখানে রানীগঞ্জে যারা এফেক্টেড হয়েছে, দোকান ঘর পড়ে গেছে, আহত হয়েছেন, তারা কয়েকজন আসবেন ওখানে বাবুদা এবং রাজ্যপালের সঙ্গে দেখা করে.